And how that opportunity came was you reach out to someone with the intent to just listen to another person, exactly. Period.
That's it. And he wasn't even a realtor at that time. He became a realtor afterwards. He started his business at a different real estate company, but still having the same trouble with his life.
It was just hanging there. The license was just really hanging. And now it's not. I mean, 90 transactions in a year is a lot of helping a lot of people. These are, well, not transactions. I should go back. Not transactions with you. It's relationships. Now exactly. He built 90 relationships.
Exactly. So what he did is he just carbon copied what I taught him. Now he is teaching his teammates. Now he's got 4 people in his team. And he's, you know, he's teaching just like the way I taught him. This way, you know, I cannot really spend so much time with every single agent.
Of course.
We teach the agents and keep them in a team where they get learn even more and they get more attention. So of course, we do the trainings every once in a while, only on the subjects that really makes difference on the agent's business.
So you consistently train with them on things that will completely add value to them, not just training every day for random reasons, just hearing people talk.
Well, I mean, there are companies who does a lot of trainings. We only do trainings on what is important in that business. Like, for example, as I said, we train them on case studies.
Okay.
Meaning, this realtor got in trouble. We look at all the case studies through the real estate commission, and this agent got fined $30,000 or $10,000, whatever the case is. We study those case studies with them to show them this agent got in trouble because of this reason. So this tells you not to do this in your business. Once you show them the worst case scenarios that can happen to them in their real estate life, they tend to get them, you know, in distant from those type of scenarios. So once you teach them that, I think they are more successful. Of course, processing is something different.
Yeah. Well, it seems like your whole ethos is take the risk on something after looking at it and saying, all right, this is what could go right, this is what could go wrong. Do it anyway. That's who you are. Learn from all the things that happen that don't work out so then you can teach someone else that, whether that's your client or whether that's someone that works with you in an organization.